All the world's a stage and all of us merely actors, said Shakespeare many decades ago. And today, all the spiritual gurus are saying the same thing. The universe unfolds a drama and all of us play our parts. To make life more interesting, Epilogue Media presents a new show, Rangmanch, where we introduce you to theatre personalities from all genres and languages. These actors, writers, directors will share their characters and vision. So get ready for an interesting behind-the-scenes stories. I'm Bhawana Somaaya, and you are listening to me on podcast show on Epilogue Media, Rangmanch. Today's episode is on Mita Vasisht. Mita Vasisht is an NSD graduate and has worked with the finest filmmakers of all genres. She has flirted with all mediums, the stage, television and cinema, but her heart beats for theatre, and which is why, no matter how busy she gets, she takes out time periodically to do plays. Of the many plays she has performed, one play continues to haunt her. Premiered in 2019 and continuing in 2020, Mita combines a play, a film and the poet within Lal Ded. Directed, conceptualized and performed by Mita Vasisht, Lal Ded is a solo act, a theatrical collage of poems, songs, thoughts and philosophies of the medieval poetess from Kashmir. Introducing our guest today, Mita Vasisht. So welcome, Mita, to my podcast show, which is called Rangmanch.
Thank you.
And I read the press note of your new play.
Yes.
And it sounded very exciting to me.
Yes.
Because it is experimenting with many forms altogether.
Yes.
So tell me, how did you get into this space and why did you think that you needed to do a play at this point?
Well, actually, the play is always new, but this is my 16th year of performance.
Okay.
So possibly in another 9 years, I can do a silver jubilee of this particular play itself.
Okay.
But the thing with this play is you don't see it so much in your face because it deals with the Kashmiri mystic poet Lal Ded.
So when did you launch this?
The first show was done in 2004, December, 1st December.
Okay.
After that, there was a hiatus for 6 months because I needed to do it the way I thought it should be done, which is when it happened in May in the India Habitat Center Festival for the first time. And what you see now is the way it was then conceived. It's been an interesting journey with the play where Lal Ded is quite a strange power, I would say, because you have to climb a lot of mountains inside yourself to first of all reach her. She doesn't allow you to reach her carefully. So mujhe 3 saal lage sirf research mein aur mujhe ek pura saal laga floor pe uska aesthetic dhoondne mein ki is inke jo shabd hain aur jo structure hai isko main apne sharir ke zariye kis tarah se prastut karun.
Acha sabse pehle to aap bataiye ye subject ke bare mein kyunki sabko inke bare mein jankari nahi hai.
Lal Ded jo hai wo 14th sadi ki Kashmiri mystic poet hai, aurat hai, शैवाइट हैं बोलती हूँ क्योंकि वो थी नहीं किसी के लिए, हैं अभी भी.
अच्छा.
शैवाइट तांत्रिक थी तो कश्मीर की हैं और कश्मीर में जितने हिंदू मुसलमान हैं कश्मीरी वो सब उनके लिए वो एक शेयर्ड आइकन है और सब ये मानते हैं कि वो शैव तांत्रिक थी और 700 साल पहले थी लेकिन आज भी अगर किसी भी आप ढंग के बुजुर्ग कश्मीरी को जिन जो कश्मीर माने पिछले 20 साल पहले के कश्मीर में बड़े पले हैं जन्मे हैं उनसे अगर आप पूछें तो हर कोई लल्ला लल्लेश्वरी लल देद को जानता है और मीरा कबीर और इन सब महाकवियों जो जिन लोगों ने अपने वातावरण को अपने समय में जिन्होंने प्रभावित किया उससे कहीं ज़्यादा इनका इन्फ्लुएंस है क्योंकि वो उनकी रोज़मर्रा की ज़िंदगी में है कश्मीरियों की. तो जैसे आप और मेरी बातचीत है और हम दोनों कश्मीरी हैं तो कुछ एक जगह पर हम कुछ बातचीत कर रहे हैं तो अचानक हम एक ललवाक छोड़ देंगे बीच में. अगर आप कहें मुझे जाना था जर्नलिज्म में लेकिन मैं चली गई कॉरपोरेट सेक्टर में और आपने वो कॉरपोरेट सेक्टर इसलिए चूज़ किया क्योंकि आपको पैसे चाहिए थे, नाम चाहिए था, ऐशो आराम चाहिए था और आपको लगा मेरी चाहत तो जर्नलिज्म है लेकिन मुझे मैं वहाँ जाऊँगी. फिर आप 5 साल बाद मुझे कहो कि मेरी तो मीता मेरी तो हालत ख़राब है और ये दुनिया बड़ी गंदी है और माने दुनिया बेकार है और मैं तो ख़त्म हो गई और यू नो आई एम अ सेंसिटिव सोल एंड यू नो द वर्ल्ड इज़ हॉरिबल. देन आई विल से टू यू भावना कुसमारी तकसमारन if we are Kashmiris and you will understand. And what I'm saying to you is tumhe kisne mara kaise mare tum, tumne apne aap ko to patak ke rakh diya ek taraf aur tumne duniya ko kaha mujhe wo duniya chahiye to tumne khud ko mara hai. So like I'll say to you, kusmari taka smaran mari kustamaran kas. Who kills, who dies, who killed you, how did you die? You said go, go, go to the self. You said come, come, come to the world. You died. You know, nice. So this is the kind of poet she is. This is the way the Kashmiris. So a Kashmiri friend of mine told me once.
Kuch baatein samajh mein nahi aa rahi hai, jaise, you say that she was there, she is there.
Yes.
So is she there through her poetry or?
Only through her poetry.
So she is dead.
She was like, she lived for 80 years till the age of 80. There are many myths about
her. There are many myths about her. What I read is that she didn't wear any clothes.
She never wore any clothes. She left home at the age of 17. She discarded.
But why didn't she wear any clothes?
Because for her, the body is already a garment for the inner deep soul.
Okay.
And what do I need another garment for?
And that was not a big controversy.
No, in fact, when I spoke to the Kashmiris this time, I also made a film called She of the Four Names, which they'll also be showing. Many Kashmiri, jo jitne jo the, jo wahan ke Kashmiri, kehte haan, wo to nangi ghoomti thi. So I said, to koi problem nahi thi. Kehti nahi, kyunki unke paas dev drishti thi na. Mane unme dev shakti thi. She was so blessed by, she was such a high consciousness ki kisi aam aadmi ko agar aap nanga dekho to aapki vision perverted ho sakti hai, lekin jab aise logon ko aap nanga dekhte ho to aapki apni drishti mein parivartan aa jata hai, to aap unko ek us gandi nazar se dekh hi nahi sakte. This is a Kashmiri's, aam Kashmiri fellow sitting in a Kashmiri camp telling me this. So I've heard it from the Kashmiri speak themselves ki she was such a high consciousness that her nakedness could not pervert our gaze.
To आपको इसके बारे में किसने बताया एंड व्हाई डिड यू वांट टू डू दिस?
यू नो भावना, व्हेन आई वाज इन माय लेट 30s, आई काइंड ऑफ फिगर्ड दैट एज विमेन वी गो थ्रू अ लॉट ऑफ फेजेस इन आवर लाइव्स, बिकॉज व्हेन यू आर 19 यू आर वेरी वाइड आइड अबाउट द वर्ल्ड, देन यू कम इनटू योर 20s एंड यू थिंक आई ओन माय बॉडी एंड आई कैन डू व्हाट आई वांट विद इट एंड इट्स नोबडीज बिजनेस. सो एक्चुअली यू एंड अप अब्यूजिंग योरसेल्फ क्वाइट अ लॉट बिकॉज यू थिंक इट्स सो ग्रेट टू बी एबल टू लिव द वे यू वांट टू हैव इन मी व्हाटएवर रिलेशनशिप्स यू वांट. इफ आई डोंट वांट अ चाइल्ड आई वोंट हैव अ चाइल्ड. सो बेसिकली यू ऑल्सो अब्यूज द ग्रेट फेमिनिन पावर दैट यू आर.
नाइस.
एंड यू टेक ऑन अ लॉट ऑफ वेस्टर्न आइडियाज ऑफ फेमिनिज्म व्हिच आर एक्चुअली सो मैस्कुलिन ओरिएंटेड.
Yes.
They're always asking you to become a man.
Yes.
Okay. Now, by the time I reached my third, and because I'm an actress, I've always been very, and a theater actress, I would say, because my training is there. So the first thing you do is to engage with the landscape of the body. You have to. Otherwise, you can't be a theater person.
You can't be another character.
You can't be another character. So you have to engage with the landscape of the body. And via, because the body, the breath, the mind, the emotion, everything is so connected that one can influence the other. So it's almost like a very yogic practice, because once you have mastered the body, its impetus, and realize how the breath changes, you can then control the breath to change the body, etc., all of that. So in that sense, my body is a landscape. My breath is the air, right, of that landscape. Everything else is so much nature that I have to understand it completely. That's the whole greatness of being a theater actress and training in the theater. And then you're living a life where you are married or you're divorced or you have your lovers or you have whatever it is. And you reach ages, different ages. So by the time you're in your 30s, you're a little more cynical about the world. You also realize maybe the body wasn't something you should have, you know, allowed such access to in the name of love or the name of desire or whatever it is.
Beautiful.
You know, and then you come into your 40s. And I realized, as an actress, I was very conscious of these stages. But when I spoke to friends who were not from the acting profession, for them, they had the same issues. But there was no articulation of it or understanding of it.
True.
So, you know, we women are living so much. We have common experiences, which a lot of us are not articulating. We have different stages in our life. We are like the young spring, then we are like the summer, then we are like the autumn, then we become the winter. And I said, there are all these seasons to a woman's life. And at every stage, this season is determined by some of the world telling you how you should live it. I said, how can it be like this? This is not how it is. And so I got fed up of all the feminist literature that I was reading, you know, all the great European feminist literature, blah, play, play. And I, of course, I'm an actress, so I want to act. So I said, ek panchvi awaz kahin to hogi, jo aurat hogi, aur jiski awaz in sab cheezon se free hai, jiski taraf jo mujhe chahiye, jisko main perform karungi. And then I started reading the women poets, the bhakti and the mystic poets. And I read them for a year and had 20 of them on my platter.
Like who, which were the others?
Like Akka Mahadevi, Andal, Meera, Mukta Bai, Jana Bai, this one, that one, so many of them. And then I somehow brought it down to four, thinking main charon ke beech mein kuch karke. So there was Meera, there was Andal. Strangely, both Vaishnavites, Krishna and Vishnu. Then there was Akka Mahadevi, again a Shaivite, but from Karnataka. And then there was Lal Ded from Kashmir and Shaivite. Strangely, I ended up with two Shaivites and two Vaishnavites. Then I thought I'd put them all four together in a play and create a landscape of the feminine. Right? उसके बाद क्या हुआ जब मैं इनके साथ जूझने लगी तब मुझे समझ में आया ये तो चारों का अपना ही एक सीजन है ईस्ट ज्योग्राफी हैज रिटन इमर्ज अ डिफरेंट पोएट्री विच इज नाउ आई एम व्हाई मेंशनिंग ज्योग्राफी इज बिकॉज ज्योग्राफी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन द एस्थेटिक्स ऑफ एनी क्रिएटिव वर्क सो व्हेन अक्का महादेवी स्पीक्स अबाउट शिवा शी कॉल्स हिम चिन्ना मल्लिका अर्जुन विच इज लॉर्ड व्हाइट इज जैस्मिन नाउ कर्नाटक इज फुल ऑफ फॉरेस्ट्स सैंडलवुड फॉरेस्ट जैस्मिन creepers and all of that so her references are all about the forest the smell of the forest the flowers of the forest and her lord shiva is and strangely she also roamed naked huh? she also was the other one who roamed naked so something about the shaivites followers makes the women just discard their clothes which is interesting and andal was from a riverine tradition the land has got rivers she's from Tamil Nadu, so where she grew up was by the river, etc. So all her references are of the water flowing, of Krishna stealing the clothes. And some of her poetry is also very sensuous, which the temple never recites because she says things like, she scolds Krishna, Vishnu and says, what the hell? You have made me wait for you for so long that next time if I ever see you, as in when you reveal yourself to me, I will tear these breasts that have known no gain and fling them at your face.
Nice.
You know, now, obviously, the temple doesn't recite these verses of this 16-year-old. And she had decided at the age of 16 that I'm to marry Vishnu, the Lord, you know. So those are her references of the river, the temples by the river and all. Then Meera. Meera is the desert. And the language has the texture of the desert.
And a princess. Mere,
and a princess. And she says, Mere Rano Ji, Mai Govind Gun Gaana. Mere Rano Ji. And it's like a Rano Ji. It's like the grittiness of the sand. The language has that, you know. And it's, again, a language of a vast space. So the music is like that. It calls out. And then there is Lal Ded, who's from this high mountain, clear, cold air, where your intellect is very, very sharp. All the rishis and munis, if you know, came from Kashmir. Aryoga is from Kashmir. Aryabhat is from Kashmir. The mathematicians are from Kashmir. The Ayurveda is from Kashmir. Charaka. The aesthetics, Abhinav Gupta, the Vedas are supposed to have, you know, emerged from that Rishi civilization. Rishi meant these were very high, they were like high consciousnesses which downloaded a lot of knowledge, tuck, 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 like our computers do, you know. So that her poetry was very different. Her poetry had the landscape of Kashmir. So she would say, by mastering the vital breaths, I cut through the six forests till the moon woke up in me. Now, nice. The six forests, I later realized, were the six chakras she was referring to in the human body.
Mm.
Now, I realized I can't put these four women in one place. It's like putting four geographies. And finally, I found myself...
So, how long you were reading all this?
I read it for almost 2.5 years. And then
were
I finally...
Were you commissioned this subject to...
No, it was a passion with me. And initially, Ford Foundation then commissioned it because I took it to them. And I said, I want to do Lal Ded and Kashmiri mystic poet. And I had Kashmiri friends and they would... talk about Lal Ded a lot. And I was fascinated by the life, also more by the poetry, because it was, A, it did not beg and plead any god to come to her. She, in fact, says, Shiva of the dark blue throat, you have your six powers, I have my six. Between you and me, there's no difference. There's nice. Just one. You are the lord of the six, meaning six senses ke tum malik ho, aur main six senses se mar jati hun. They kill me. Those six senses are always leading me astray. And you are the Lord who has mastered the six senses. So she talks about Shiva as a yogi and she talks about herself as a yogi who can reach him. And she finally does, you know. So for a lot of Kashmiri, she is the female Shiva, actually, you know. And for Muslims as well, you know. So, yes, it was initially commissioned.
So after reading all this, how did you kind of zero in on her?
She just took me towards her with her poetry.
And how did you form this production?
Then the production got formed. I went looking for the aesthetic because aesthetic is very important. Content is one thing, but how do you put it? In what form do you put it? So then I started saying, ek to poetry, unki 30 poems maine choose ki. तो ये पोएट्री जब आप बोलोगे तो आप खड़े होके तो बड़े एनिमेटेड तरीके से बोल नहीं सकते हो, प्लस कश्मीरी लैंग्वेज है. और मैं आपको बड़ा एक अजीब किस्सा बताऊँ इसका, एक इस तरह ढूंढते ढूंढते मैं कहाँ कहाँ नहीं चली गई. मैं पौंडीचेरी तक पहुँच गई जहाँ पे वीणा पानी का आदिशक्ति था जिनके साथ मैंने काम किया था, एंड शी हैड दिस थिएटर कंपनी. देन यू नो आई डिसाइड आई विल गो देयर एंड ट्राई एंड स्टडी सम वे ऑफ फाइंडिंग फ्रॉम द इंडियन ट्रेडिशनल फॉर्म्स हाउ टू फाइंड अ जेस्चर फॉर ईच पोएम, कि हाउ डू यू शो द मून, द सन, द मून वोक अप इन मी, एंड देन डिस्टिल दोज जेस्चर्स टू क्रिएट अ जेस्चर विच इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ देम येट हैज द रूट ऑफ हैज द एसेंस. सो बेसिकली हम जो थिएटर एक्टर्स होते हैं, स्पेशली कॉन्टेम्प्रेरी एक्टर्स होते हैं, हमारा कोई देश नहीं है क्योंकि हम किसी ट्रेडिशन को बिलोंग नहीं करते हैं. मैं तो फौजी की बेटी थी तो हमारा तो ट्रेडिशन और भी, माने हमारा सब कुछ हमारा है लेकिन कुछ भी नहीं है एज एन एक्टर. जैसे कि आप भरतनाट्यम डांसर हैं तो आपके पास नाट्य शास्त्र, बाय द वे वी कम फ्रॉम द सेम थिंग, द एक्टर्स एंड द ग्रेट क्लासिकल, ऑल द क्लासिकल डांसेस कम फ्रॉम द नाट्य शास्त्र, सो यू विल नो एग्जैक्टली व्हाट आई एम सेइंग भावना. सो द कंटेम्प्रेरी एक्टर हैज़ अ प्रॉब्लम कि देर इज नथिंग ऑफ अ ट्रेडिशन टू फॉल बैक ऑन. Where do you find your language? और आपकी जो आदतें हैं वो एक बार तो लग सकता है बड़ी अच्छी एक्टिंग कर ली, दूसरी बार तो जाहिर हो जाएगा कि ये तो इसकी आम आदत है, ये तो है ही ऐसी, ये इसकी हैबिट्स हैं जिस तरह वो बोलती है, उठती है, बैठती है. तो फर्स्ट फिल्म या फर्स्ट थिएटर प्ले में आप निकाल सकते हैं. अगले बहुत सारे कैरेक्टर्स आपको बनाने हैं तो आपको कहीं से तो तलाशना पड़ेगा कि मुद्रा कहाँ से आएगी. और उस मुद्रा तो मुझे लगा सिर्फ क्लासिकल ट्रेडिशन जैसे भरतनाट्यम या कूडियाट्टम यहाँ से मैं कुछ ढूंढूं, हाँ, ऑफ द जेस्चर. तो पांडिचेरी में मुझे वो उषा नांगिया जो कुडियाट्टम की जो पहली फीमेल डांसर हैं बड़ी महान, वो थी वहाँ पे आदिशक्ति में वीणा के ग्रुप में. तो मैंने उनसे पूछा कि कुडियाट्टम में आप कैसे करेंगे व्हेन इफ आई हैव टू से अ पोएम, बिकॉज दे रिसाइट पोएट्री.
यस,
एंड द जेस्चर क्रिएट्स इट, द डांसर क्रिएट्स इट. The poetry is recited somewhere.
Yes, yes.
है ना? The rhythm is played somewhere else.
Yes.
And the dancer creates the story through the body.
Yes.
So I felt the Indian traditions of performance, which are Bharatanatyam, Kudiyattam, these are the ones I will have to explore the language for presenting my play, which is all about poetry and the life of a mystic poet. So then I asked this Kudiyattam person, Usha Nangiyar, I said, how will you say when the I cut through the six forests till the moon woke up in me? So she, I think, did something like, you know, and then the moon woke up in me like this, you know, something she did. So I would watch her, then I would look at these gestures and I say, achha, okay. Then I would sort of try and do them, you know. So when the sun was gone, and the moon came, things like that. So, for example,
combine one of your poems with the gesture you do on stage and show.
So now, after having this, then you have to take it away. See?
You crystallize it.
You also take the essence and then, you know, it's like modern art takes from realism.
Yeah.
So then you paint it differently. So one of my, the works that I recite is, Oh Shiva of the dark blue throat. And at that time I'm sitting, by mastering the vital breaths, I cut through the six forests. This rises. Mm-hmm. Till the moon woke up in me digit by digit and the world dried up in me. You know, so then this becomes a gesture of pure theater.
Hmm.
It has come from Kudiyattam, but you don't see the Kudiyattam.
Hmm.
You've absorbed it and you've turned it into something else. So while this is rising, I cut through the six forests, the six chakras. So this palm, which is here, and this thumb, which represents the shivling, it's rising because it is the rise of the divine power.
Hmm.
And then you come up here and then the moon woke up in me. It turns into the Ardha Chandra gesture. Hmm. And in that moment, I reach Shiva. And that's when you get into the performance separately. Then I've also taken a gesture in Lal Ded from Leonardo da Vinci's Annunciation. Annunciation is the painting where Gabriel the angel comes to tell Mary that she's going to be giving birth to Jesus. It's an amazing painting. It's one of Leonardo da Vinci's classics. Annunciation series has been done by every great Renaissance painter, that particular portion. But Leonardo's is changed. It has a very serene Mary sitting like this with a hand like this. And she's got a book in front of her. And angel Gabriel is like this, leaning in front of her to give her the message, which is hand out. And this gesture, which is like, looks like an Ashirvad gesture. When I also teach. So when I was working it out with my students in the class years ago, we realized that this gesture, which looks like a gesture of blessing, If you copy it exactly as it's in the painting, with the elbow slightly pushed out, the palm straight up, but the fingers slightly curved, almost like the hood of a snake, not quite. And then the body is slightly moved away, the left shoulder is moved away, so it's not exactly frontal. And this hand has so pulled back the right elbow, which is in a gesture of blessing, you realize it's not a gesture of blessing, it's a gesture of trepidation. It's like saying, nahi. You know, it's like when you say, no, and you pull your hand back in a way. So the great masters in painting, when they paint postures, and to us they look very odd, but if you actually start settling yourself into the posture, you know, and it feels odd to the body because it's actually breaking your body habits. Nobody really sits like this. That's when you realize the emotion that is contained in that gesture, you know. And you, of course, will know that, Bhavna, because you're a Bharatnatyam dancer, so you know how the grid contains the emotion. So in my play in Lal Ded, I had to find the aesthetics, and that is when I found ways of holding the body. So right in the beginning of the play, she says, Saat janam pehle bhi main aurat thi, Pandrethan gaon mein byahi gahi thi main. Us subah baraf abhi giri nahi thi jab maine ek bacche ko janm diya. Then the guru comes and she asks him, what is my relationship with this child? And he says, this is your son. Aur wo kehti nahi, maine kaha nahi, kyunki jaldi hi main mar jaungi. She's seen her next life and she realizes this life is very... So in that, I actually use this Leonardo gesture to hand over the baby and pull away from it. So I take in the play, which is very stylized, I take gestures from Kudiyattam, from Leonardo painting, and you can't make it out because...
But how did you combine the film, the documentary or the feature film that you made on?
In the film, it was a different journey altogether because the film, I drove all the way in my Qualis car from Bombay to Jammu and Kashmir with a camera girl who was a young student from FTI, just a fresh pass out.
My God.
The three of us, only three of us girls. And then we picked up a driver from Delhi to drive us in. And we went all through interviewing all random Kashmiris everywhere to ask them what is... to figure out what is the lalla speak for them. So we were only asked...
How do you do this? Is there somebody funding you? You put
no, there was
money?
No funding here. This was just madness.
It was madness.
It's not a madness, I would
it's
say.
It's passion.
It's passion. It's driving. And you know, the funny thing with Lal Ded is that if once she allows you to come close, she doesn't. You know, there have been many interesting, weird, scary stories.
I was going to ask you.
About
does she,
people.
Does she haunt you?
She doesn't haunt, but I'll tell you when I have to tell you the story about how I first started reading Kashmiri Mein Lal Ded. I was in Veena Pani's guest house. It was a rainy night. Now, Veena has a very funny, weird sense of humor. Veena is no more, but she was this weirdo who would tell you. Weirdo in a very affectionate way, I'm saying. So she has this vast campus of 2 acres. There's a guest house there, very beautifully done in the South Indian architecture and all, 2 floors. There was nobody going to be living there except for me. She was in her little bungalow. The other actors were in their little bungalows, residential. So it's raining and she's saying, oh, Mita, be careful when you walk to the bungalow. You know, sometimes the snakes drop off the trees. I'm like, oh. So I'm already spooked out. So I reach... Then I'm in this guest house, which has 12 rooms upstairs, 12 rooms downstairs, a central courtyard with a tulsi podha and thunder and lightning all around. And I'm alone. But anyway, I go to sleep. It's a campus. It's a theater space. Very nice. Beautifully done. But nice in nature. And I wake up suddenly at something like 3 in the morning, perhaps. And I find there's a man standing in the next to my bed and looking down at me. And he's wearing this little
mundu,
the little thing. The chest is bare and he's swaying slightly and he's looking at me. And the funny thing is that I can see the rest of the room through him. So I can see the cupboard at the back. I can see the door to the bathroom and I can see the desk to the side where all my Lal Ded material is lying. And I'm looking at this strange scepter out there and I'm like saying, ye kya hai? And then he's looking at me slightly and I can make out he's a little drunk.
My God.
Yes. And he's inebriated and he's swaying slightly and it's like he's got a strange, leering look about him. And I'm like saying, no, I haven't been celibate that long to be imagining these things, for God's sake, what's going on? So I shut my eyes tightly and I started chanting some Hanuman Chalisa, so I don't know what mantra, like a maniac. To me, it was like loud as anything. And my body was like frozen. I couldn't even get up. You know, it's like a nimbus you get when you're sleeping sometimes. And then opened my eyes slightly and he was still there. And I just went on chanting my prayers. And then I opened and he had left. And it was raining. And then I couldn't go to sleep. So I switched on the lamp. And I said, what should I do now? And I had read enough of Lal Ded, the translations about her. I'd read her translations in Hindi and English and what people had to say for her and her poetry. But I had never, ever read her in her own words, which is Kashmiri. So suddenly I sat there, my heart thudding because of this strange experience. And I said, what should I do now? And I had to do something that I had never done. So there was this book in front of me, which had Lal Ded in Kashmiri, but in the Hindi lipi. So that's the first time I started reading Kashmiri. And it was the first time when I started reading Kashmiri, I suddenly realized, oh my God, this is the rhythm in which she spoke. So that is the first time I read. So I read it very tentatively first. Kusamaritokos. And then when it became easier, it was like Kusmaritakasmaran Marikustamaran Kus.
What does that mean?
It's the vak that I told you earlier. Who kills, who dies. But listen to the rhythm, Bhavna. Kusmaritakasmaran Marikustamaran Kus. Yus hare hare trevit gare gare kare adsumritamaran tas. You know, there's such a cadence to the whole thing. Okay? There's such a cadence to the vachik here. And it means who kills, who dies, who kills you, how did you die? You said go, go, go to the self. You said come, come, come to the world. You killed the self, you died. Now I've put my own English rhythm in it. That is when I understood the precision of her language, the rhythm of her language. And that's when I realized, oh my God, my play has to have Kashmiri in it. I have to speak in Kashmiri. I can't speak the way the Kashmiris speak. They have a slightly thickish tongue. So they might say, Kosmarit, Kosmaran. But I'm not there to imitate. I'm there to give the phonetics and to say the words she said, you know. So that determined the style, the aesthetics, lots of things. Because when you're presenting the words of a great poet, you don't try and emote them. Because emoting is very limited. I put an emotion in it. What does it mean? You have to free the word.
But that's an oft-used phrase.
Yes.
That's an oft-used phrase by actors. You know, I put a lot of emotion into my character.
Which is really crappy, actually, you know. Because I'll tell you why. Because emotion is very individual. And you might say this is the motivation. But when you're talking with a great poet, you also have to understand that words are very magical things. They're made up of sounds and syllables. It's a whole world out there in the body of the language. Because the syllable carries rhythm, sounds. They are sounds from many million years ago. What emotion does very often, especially when actors are overpowering the word with emotion, is that they crush the word and they don't allow it to release its fragrance.
So you sound completely consumed by your subject and you are happy in that space.
Yes.
And you're fragrant in that space. What will happen once your show and performance is over? Are you going to miss her?
No,
is she going to travel with you inside you, around
you? Actually, you know, Bhavna, it's very strange. Much as I would like to transcend and get into that space, living the way I do with my body, sometimes it's impossible. See, this is my 16th year of performance. I've never pushed her shows. Yeah. Because you can't market her in that sense. She goes where she wants to go, you follow. And I remember years ago, so basically I have already done some 40 shows over 15 years. And they've been this, like last year I performed at Gurgaon at the Biodiversity Festival and all of that. Now, the funny thing is that it's a very physically demanding performance. And in fact, somebody asked me this question, a very dear old lady. She asked me, she said, but Meeta, jab tumne shuru kiya tha, tab to tum 15 saal choti thi. तो शरीर पे अब असर नहीं पड़ता है तुमको प्रॉब्लम नहीं होती कि माने आफ्टर ऑल इट्स नॉट द सेम एज व्हेन यू आर मच यंगर टू बी डूइंग ऑल दिस सो आई टोल्ड हर आई सेड यू नो समथिंग हैपेंस व्हेन आई स्टार्ट एंगेजिंग विद हर इज दैट वंस आई एम ऑन स्टेज एंड यू इफ यू सी द शो भावना आई डू स्ट्रेंज थिंग द शो बिगिंस विद एन अपटर्न्ड हेड सो आई हैव एक्चुअली टेकन अ होल इनवर्टेड पोस्चर यू नो आई सेड समहाउ यू फॉरगेट द बॉडी जस्ट गेट्स अ सर्टेन एनर्जी व्हिच इज डिफरेंट यू नो. And the reason I keep engaging with shows of hers because she keeps bringing me back to the purer self. The purer self, I can't always maintain.
So you are the producer, director, actor, writer. Everything.
There have been collaborators at every phase. You know, there have been collaborators. For example, the initial research phase was done with Bansi Kaul and Anjana, who are theatre people in Bhopal. And the music was done by Anjana, the songs that the works that I sing. And she's a very beautiful composer. Then later on, somehow things, it's very strange with Lal Ded. I have journeyed with many people, and at some point of time, they've just left me or dropped out. And then I journey alone, and then I find somebody else who'll add to something of it collaboratively.
And you move on again.
Then they drop off, or they start doing things which become very, strangely, they become unpleasant. They want to possess her, and then she moves on, and then I follow her. So it's happened like that at every stage. So the direction, the scripting happened. I had all the material and everything together, and then the structuring of the script happened with Vishnu Mathur, who's a film director. Documentary and other films. This happened years ago. But then he also had some sort of strange issue with, like, no, this is the play now. This is it. And I said, no, the play has just begun. This is a grid. Now we have to do the performance. And it was like, no. And then we parted ways in a very gentle way. But that was it. And that's when...
How is performing this different from your earlier other plays? Like, I think the one before this you staged was in that Nawari Sari.
Agnipunk.
Huh.
Yes. Actually, Bhawana, it's different in the sense that with Lal Ded, I never tire. She puts me in a discipline and she doesn't allow me to seduce the audience.
Mm-hmm.
She says, you will play it as it is.
No indulgences.
No indulgences. And the funny thing is, a lot of the audiences I've had, the reactions I've had are phenomenal.
Are they mostly Kashmiris?
No, on the contrary. I had a 25-year-old girl who was actually a struggling actress in Bombay in 2014 when I performed at Prithvi. And she just stood around and she wanted to meet me. And she said, Meeta, after seeing this play, I've just realized it's all right to just follow your own path. I don't have to cater to the demand of the world.
Nice.
I've been struggling here as an actress, but now I realize I will make it on my own term and nobody else's.
Mm.
And thank you for being in the universe at the same time as I am.
Mm.
Can you imagine?
Mm.
That's a line coming from a 24-year-old.
Mm.
There are people who've seen the show at NCP, and this lady told me that she came out of the show and she didn't want to go back home. So she actually wandered off to YB Chavahan in the night and took a bus from there, which would take the long route home.
Because she wanted to be with
it. She just wanted to be with it and with herself, you know.
Mm-hmm. Have you thought of also doing a book on Lal Ded?
I've done the film. I also have a feature script on her. I actually started a feature thing. So the film has a Kashmiri speak, plus I've fictionalized a lot of it.
So would you like to play the feature film?
No, I'm very much more objective.
You want to do
When I did this film, The She of the Four Limbs, which is a docu-fiction, because I had to do it. I did it for PSBT. The budget was very low. And Kashmir shut down, so I couldn't get the freebies. It's probably a 7-8 crore film. So the only thing I've done in the film is walk naked, because I didn't want another actress to be uncomfortable walking naked. But I got a lovely young Kashmiri woman from Chandigarh.
Will you be walking naked for this?
No, on the show I can't. I have a garment, which is a muslin thing, which is almost like a no garment.
Huh.
Because it has no stitching that is apparent. So it has the illusion of becoming like a skin that floats around.
Okay.
You know, I put a little layer in front, because the first time when I did it for friends on my terrace, I had no layer in it. And my female friend said, Meeta, please, this visual of breasts peeping out is distracting to me. So think what it'll do.
Yeah.
So I said, yeah, all said and done, I'm presenting Lal Ded. I do not have the dev drishti that people will, allow my nudity to maybe not be, this thing. So I said, one presents the mystic, one is not the mystic, So
it's, when Hema Malini was playing Meera.
Yes.
And Manikol asked Gulzar.
Yes.
That why did you choose her?
Yes.
And he said, she looks saintly.
Ha 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 ha.
And Manikol said, you answered it. She looks.
Right. Right.
So that's the difference.
And it's interesting you should bring in Manikol, because in fact, when my first film was Bar Bar Vaari for Kumar Shahani, and then it was Manikol Siddheshwari, and I was a young actress, and I'm up with a director who has absolutely no patience with actors who ask questions. He doesn't want a word like motivation kya hai. So even Kumar is like that. So I bahut jaldi samajh liya ki bhaiya yahan motivation mat poocho.
Kuch baat hi mat karo.
Par karo hi mat baat. But I'm like I'm like a mop, like a sponge. I want to know, and I'm very interested in people. I'm working for, especially with directors, and if I didn't know they were geniuses, they were highly celebrated. मुझे कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता. I was fresh out of NSD. हाँ, तुम great director होगे. मैं भी अपना acting जानती हूँ. मुझे मेरा talent पता है.
बिल्कुल.
हाँ, तुम मुझे तुम्हारे सामने झुकने की ज़रूरत नहीं. I had that wonderful arrogance of this 24-year-old.
But that works.
It has to be there, Bhavna.
Yes.
As an actor, you have to have a great conviction of your talent and to respect it, because a talent is not something you produce. It's a gift.
Absolutely.
It's a gift you have to take care of. You know, you cannot get arrogant about it. At the same time, you cannot get careless about it. You know, it is like having a plant in your garden that suddenly that is there because it is there, and you have to water it nicely and nurture it nicely. You can't decide I'm the plant, you know, and therefore whatever. So I believe if I'm highly talented and I sense it and it was a calling, it's not something I'm proud of. It's not something I can take credit for. I think in the creative line, when we are gifted, we are gifted. And it's something that comes from God, and you have to take damn good care of it.
Yes.
You know? So money, to main to samajh gaya theek hai, aap hoge great director. So I was very interested ki iska dimag kaise kaam karta hai, is director ka. So I started listening to everything he said to anyone. He would sell something to the cameraman, I would take notes, and then I would say, how would I interpret this in terms of acting? So money was the one who would say, you are not Siddheshwari. Because if I had to cast somebody who was to be realistic, then I would have cast a plump woman with a round face. Okay? And I was just like 24, 5 years. I was patla, slender.
Yeah, yeah, I remember you. I've seen
yes.
the film. Yeah.
So he said, you have to present her spirit. You have to do things so that the world begins to see her, to hear her, to imagine her. And I realized you have to do that through the craft. And that has actually influenced. So when I perform Lal Ded, the subject is such that it's she's amazing. She takes me to a different level. But no matter what performance I do, I like to enter it like entering something else, which doesn't say I have become that. It's like I'm presenting this. So what is the gesture which is right for this? What is the tone of voice which is right for this? What is the speed of that speech which will be right
for this? I love this, what you said. It's not that I've done this, I'm presenting this.
I'm presenting this. And in order to present it...
It reminds me of Amitabh Bachchan. So I was with him when he was dubbing. And the engineer said, sir, take care. So he said, koshish karte hai.
Lovely, na?
Look at the modesty.
Yes, but it is a koshish always.
And... it is something I feel to learn from.
Yes.
So now when I am at the radio and they say, ke, madam, take kare kya? So I say, koshish karte
hai.
Kyunki you don't know if it's going to happen.
Yes.
You know, in that 1 minute, your throat can go wrong. Anything can happen.
Yes, yes.
It will just not come.
Maybe. Yeah.
Yeah.
And also the thing is, when you say koshish, basically you're not saying I'm doing it.
Yeah.
You know, I'm letting it.
Yes.
I'm putting an effort to make it happen,
because
if possible.
All these great poets, when you say irshad
yes.
to them for their fabulous lines,
yes.
And agar poochho aapke kaise kiya tha, to they say, wo sher ho gaya.
Ho gaya, haan.
Kabhi koi nahi kehta hai ki maine likha.
In fact, Bhavna, this is what is so beautiful in the theatre, because when the performance goes beautifully, you feel so graced that you feel actually humbled.
Yes.
You want to bow down and touch, you know, you want to bow down in front of everyone who was there sitting and participating in this presentation, because the audience participates. You know why I love the theater and why I actually became an actress in the theater, and why I became, meaning years ago when there was no television, was because it is the one space where you have to completely be forgiving, because if you're not, the performance won't happen. So I said, theater, being a theater actress,
Rangmanch,
it doesn't allow you to bear a grudge. Because if you have a grudge with your co-actor, you will never be able to get into the scene. So aapko show ke pehle har kisi ko har cheez maaf kar deni padti hai. Karna zaruri hai. Agar aap chahte hain us level tak pahunchna.
Meditative performance.
Haan. Aur phir jab aap wahan pahunch gaye, to phir aapko to kisi se naraaz hone ki zarurat hi nahi hai. क्योंकि वो एक अलग ही जगह में आप घूम रहे हैं, यू नो, आप फिर 3 दिन तक आपके पैर थोड़े से जमीन से ऊपर उठे हुए होते हैं, यू नो, आप तैर रहे होते हैं कहीं पे.
द प्योरिटी ऑफ अ परफॉर्मर एंड व्हाट ही और शी गेट्स फ्रॉम हर क्राफ्ट एंड व्हेन शी आर्टिकुलेट्स इट, द विजडम दैट द पर्सन हु इज लिसनिंग टू गेट्स एंड हाउ इट ट्रांसफॉर्म्स योर ओन प्योरिटी. So it's wonderful to be associated and surrounded by sensitive artists, because you are growing every minute.
Yes, that's the whole attempt, because if you don't, you're finished.
Yes. Wonderful.
Thanks, Bhavana.
Thank you for tuning in. If you have liked this episode, do comment. Do rate on Apple Podcasts. Subscribe to Rangmanch on your favorite podcast app like Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Hubhopper, Castbox, Spotify, JioSaavn, so that you get notified when we come next. Stay tuned for the next episode with yet another guest. And until then, take great care of yourself.